Hey guys, welcome to this video lecture series on the subject of polymer science and technology. I'm Harsh Panchal, assistant professor in chemical engineering department of LJ Institute of Engineering and Technology. Well, in a previous lecture, we have classified polymer based on the monomeric chain as linear polymer, branched polymer, and cross-link polymer. And we have also classified polymer based on the monomer as random polymer, alternative polymer, grafted polymer, homopolymer, and copolymer. Well, all these classifications are very important for the exam point of view. So if you have missed that video, you can find it in the I button over here. Now, having said that, let's just continue our classification of the polymer. Well, in this video, we will see classification of the polymer based on molecular forces. Well, this intermolecular forces of different monomer joining together is very important to determine their mechanical properties, their tensile strength and density. Well, there are basically two different bonds or two different molecular forces. One is the van der Waal bond and another one is the hydrogen bond. So all the monomer will connect or join with these two bonds. So basically the magnitude of this force determine or classify the polymers. There are four different categories under this tag as elastomer, fiber, then thermosetting, and lastly we will have thermoplastic polymers. So let's just start with the elastomer. Well, here in the screen you can see that the polymer chain which are held together by weak van der Waal bonds are considered as the elastomer. So the polymers which are joined or linked with the van der Waal bonds can be considered as the elastomer. We have already seen this van der Waal bond is basically weak bond. So this van der Waal bond provide the elasticity in the polymer. As you can see in this image, this structure of the polymer is being connected with the weak van der Waal bond. Here the red line shows the weak van der Waal bonds. So basically this bond provide elasticity to the polymer, and hence we consider this polymer as the elastomer. So now having said that, let's move to the next type of the polymer, that is fiber. Well, you can see on the screen, this fiber are joined or held together with the strong hydrogen bond. It is not that easy to break out this hydrogen bond. Hence the fiber molecules are very tightly packed and very close to each other. They are providing thread-like properties. So now you can see on the screen, fiber have the strong force of interaction between them, such as hydrogen bond. Hence, they have strong, tough and high tensile strength. Their density is also very high. Due to this strong interaction force, the chain are closely packed and hence they have crystalline structure. Mainly, they have thread-like properties. This fiber has very high melting point since they are connected with each other in a close manner. Their example are nylon and silk. You can see in this image the structure of the fiber. As you can see here with the pointer, that this structure is being connected with very close packing, and the bond between them is the hydrogen bond. So it is not that much easy to break out this bond. Hence the fiber has very much rigid type of the properties. This is the example of the cellulose fiber. Now, having said that, let's move to the third category of the polymer based on the molecular forces, and that is thermoplastic polymers. Well, in the thermoplastic polymer, the intermolecular forces are in between hydrogen and van der Waals bond. So we can say that this is the mixture of elastomer and fibers. You can see on the screen that these have intermediate forces of attraction to the adjacent polymer chain. They are held together by either van der Waals bond or by the hydrogen bond. The thermoplastic polymer become soft on heating and stiffened on the cooling. So this is the main property of the thermoplastic polymers. You must have seen the polypropylene transparent pipes. These pipes become soft on the application of the heat, and we tied this pipe with the nozzle, and upon cooling this pipe get hard so that they will connect it with the nozzle. Now, having said that, this thermoplastic polymer can be reshaped or remolded. Basically, the intermolecular forces of this thermoplastic material are responsible for their remold and reshape. They have either linear or branch structure. When this thermoplastic polymer have linear or branch structure, well, they do not have cross-drilling structure. If they have cross-drilling structure, they will lose their thermoplastic properties. So, molecules with the linear or branched structure can only form thermoplastic polymers. The basic example of these thermoplastic polymers are polyethylene, polypropylene, or polyvinyl chloride. So, here in this image, you can see that the intermolecular forces between adjacent monomer are in between hydrogen bond and van der Waals bond. Here in the image, you can see that the example of the nylon polymer. Now, having said that, let's move to the last category of the polymer based on the molecular force, and that is thermosetting polymers. Well, you can see on the screen, these thermosetting polymers have very strong covalent bond and they are cross-linkedly connected. So, because of this strong covalent form, it is not easy to break out bond, so they will not have thermoplastic properties. So, it is not easy to remold or reshape this type of the polymer. The thermosetting polymers have three-dimensional structure which is connected with the cross-line network. So, this is the main reason that this type of the polymer have rigid type of properties. Now, these thermosetting polymers have greatly improved material's mechanical property. It provides enhanced chemical and heat resistance. They are bitter polymers, so they can be easily broken up. The example of these thermosetting polymers are phenol formaldehyde, urea formaldehyde, and melamine. So now, this was the classification of the polymer based on the molecular force acting between them. This thermosetting and thermoplastic polymer are again very important for the university exam. Now, having said that, this concludes the classification of the polymer. We have seen the classification of polymer based on the source of originality as natural polymer and synthetic polymer. Then we have seen the classification of polymer based on the structure chain of the monomer as linear polymer, branched polymer, and cross-linked polymer. Then we have seen elastomer, fiber, thermoplastic, and thermosetting polymers. Now let's move to the next topic of the effect of functionality on the polymer. Well, I have already described what do we mean by the functionality in the second video. If you have missed that video, you can find it in the I button over here. Now, let me just again give you brief introduction to the functionality. Well, the functionality can be defined as the number of active site on the monomer by which a monomer can be connected or linked with the another monomer. Now, here we will see what are the effect of this functionality on the polymer. In the case of functionality F is equal to 2, the monomer can form only linear or branched polymer. To form cross-linked polymer, the functionality of the monomer should be equal to 3 or greater than 3. So this is the first effect that polymer with the functionality of 2 can only form linear or branched polymer. In order to form cross-link network, the monomer should have functionality equal to 3 or greater than 3. Having said that, now let me just take a pen so that I can explain you this effect of functionality on the polymer. Well, here on the screen you can see that this ethylene molecule basically has a functionality of a 2. Hence, the 4 hydrogen are being connected in this fashion. Now, if I have to make a polymer out of it, this will undergo polymerization reaction and it will have the polymer in this way. Let's consider the 4 carbon atom and this chain is being continued to follow. Now, this carbon will be connected with 2 hydrogen in this way. This carbon can also be connected with 2 hydrogen in this way, and this carbon will also have 2 hydrogen. And lastly, one more hydrogen is here. So now you can see that this particular polymer is having a linear fashion, as this monomer only has 2 functionality. So it can connect in this way and in this way only. To form the crossed link polymer, it should be connected with one more functional group in one more direction. But as this ethylene molecule do not have functionality greater than 2, it has only functionality of 2, so that it can only form the linear polymer like this, or it can only form the branched polymer. So now, having said that, let me just rub all this thing so that I can explain you the next image. As you can see on the screen that this linear polymer, particularly this one, has the functionality of 2. Other polymer like this crossed link or the network polymer are having functionality equal to 3 or greater than 3. So this is the effect of the functionality on the polymer. Now this was all about the functionality greater than or equal to 2. But what about the monofunctional polymer? Well, you can see here on the screen, these are the 2 molecules that are having the monofunctional group as this. Now, let me just show you one example of acetic acid, that is CH3COOH, which is connected with the ethylene group or ethanol like this. So, this particular acetic acid has one functional group as COOH, and this ethanol molecule or methanol molecule has functional group of OH. So both will having the only one functional group, they are the monofunctional polymers or monofunctional monomers. Now if they undergo polymerization reaction, they will form the chemical structure like this, CH3 C double bond CH3. Now there is no further active group or no further functional group which can be connected with another monomer. So we can say that the monofunctional monomer cannot form long chain of the polymer. Hence, they are not considered for the polymerization reaction. The reactive group on the acid, that is acetic acid and alcohol, are used up completely, and that the product ester, this one is the ester, is incapable of further esterification or polymerization reaction. Hence, this monofunctional monomer do not use in the polymerization reaction. In order to form polymer, the monomer must be at least bifunctional so that we can have the continuous chain of the polymer. Since monofunctional monomer terminate the polymer chain and effectively it bring polymerization reaction to halt. So we can see in this reaction, this polymerization reaction is being stopped after this particular ester product. Now this ester cannot further undergo the polymerization reaction. So this was all about the effect of functionality on the polymer. We will see you in the next video. Till then, keep watching, keep learning. Thank you.